In the seventh question, we have under root of 1 plus 3x minus x square. How do we handle this? Once again, we'll have to focus on creating a perfect square over there. 1 plus 3x minus x square can be written as minus of x square minus 3x minus 1, which becomes okay, x minus 3 by 2 whole square minus 1 minus the square of this, which is 9 by 4. Minus 1 minus 9 by 4 will be minus 13 by 4 into minus will be 13 by 4 minus x minus 3 by 2 square. This is what you have. Okay, so you have converted the integrand, the under root expression in terms of a perfect square. Once you have done that, you'll need, the formula that you'll need is a square minus x square in the under root. Let me write the formula as well. Integral of under root a square minus x square dx is x by 2 under root of a square minus x square plus a square by 2 sine inverse x by a, right? Let's not make a mistake in this, plus constant. This is the required formula. This is the required formula, yes. And once we are aware of this, therefore I, the integral becomes under root of 1 plus 3x minus x square dx is equal to integral of under root that expression. Under root of this, root 13 by 4, under root will be root 13 by 2, this is square, minus x minus 3 by 2 square. This is what you have, dx. So now I can apply under root of a square minus x square, where a is root 13 by 2 and b is x minus 3 by 2. A is root 13 by 2. Let's not make a mistake in this. This is square root of 13. This is the square root of 13, right? What else? Directly applying the formula, this tells me x by 2. So x is, instead of x, you have x minus 3 by 2. Okay, and by 2 under root of x, a square minus x square, this minus this, which is actually 1 plus 3x minus x square, okay, plus a square by 2. Now what is a square? A square is this expression squared, which is 13 by 4 a square by 2 under root, sorry, what do we need after that? Sine inverse x by a square by 2, sine inverse x by a is what we are interested in. So this will be sine inverse x by a. Now what is x? This is x, a, this is a. Over root 13 by 2. This is what you have, plus constant of integration. Now the only thing that remains is simplification of this whole expression. Okay, let's take the LCM and all and simplify this. This becomes 2x minus 3 in the numerator, 2 times 2, 4 in the denominator, under root of 1 plus 3x minus x square over here. And what else? This is 13 by 8. This is 13 by 8. Sine inverse. What do we have? 2x minus 3 upon root 13. Plus constant of integration. And yes, that is my required answer for this question, as you can clearly see over here. Is that all? Yes, that's all in this seventh question.